I'm Lily. Today I'm going to read you a story, Oxford Reading Tree, Level 7. The Riddlestone, Part 1. It has Part 1 and Part 2. And today I'm going to read you The Riddlestone, Part 1. Yes, let's read it. The Riddlestone, Part 1. Dad had pulled up some floorboards. "Hello," he said. "What's this?" Under the floor was a stone. It had some strange writing on it. Dad was going to throw the stone away, but she wanted to keep it. "Look at this," he said to Biff. Do you think the writing is Chinese?" "I don't know," said Biff. Chip took the scroll to school. He showed it to a boy called Hong. It is written in Chinese," he said. "I can't read it, but my grandfather can." Hong's grandfather always came after school to take Hong's home. Chip showed him the picture. "Yes, it's Chinese," said Hong's grandfather. "It says, 'Do you mind?'" "Do you mind?" "What a strange question," said Biff. "It may be a riddle," said Hong's grandfather. "See, the stone is broken. Maybe the answer is on the other half." Chip gave Hong the stone to keep. He put it in his bag. May Hong come round to play with us? Asked Biff. "All right," said Hong's grandfather. So they went to play in Biff's room. "What's the riddle?" asked Chip. "It is a puzzle in words," said Hong. "I will give you an easy one." "Here's a good riddle," said Hong. How do you spell hungry horse using only four letters?" "We don't know," said Biff. "The answer is..." "It's easy," laughed Hong. "MTGG. I don't know why this is the answer, but let's see. Here is another riddle. What is this? The more it dries, the more it gets wet. Suddenly, the magic key began to glow. The magic took them to a rocky valley. Four paths met. There was a signpost pointing four ways. Each way pointed to Riddle Mountain. A boy was sitting on a rock. "My name is Tai," he said. "I want to go to Riddle Mountain, but I don't know which path to take. I can't think of the answer to this riddle." The riddle was on a tall post. It said, "The only one color, but it can grow. Sticks to your feet wherever you go. They're in the sun, not in the rain. Never does harm, never feels the pain." "The answer is a shadow," said Hong. "Look at the shadow in the post. It points up the path. That must be the way." "Are you sure?" asked Biff. "Yes, it's a riddle," said Tai. "Let's go." "It is hard to get to Riddle Mountain," said Tai. "It will be dangerous. I may never get there." "Then why do you have to go?" asked Biff. I want to be the riddle maker," said Tai. "I have to get to Riddle Mountain. I have to answer all the riddles on the way. The last riddle is the hardest. No one has ever found the answer." Suddenly, a huge giant stood in the way. "I hope he's friendly," said Chip. "Answer this riddle and you can pass by," roared the giant. "Write down how much I weigh," he said. "But he must weigh tons," said Biff. "No, it's a riddle," said Hong. "I can do it." He wrote down the answer. "Good luck in the land of riddles, said the giant. "What did you write?" asked Chip. "I wrote the words, 'How much I weigh,'" said Hong. "It's very clever." "It was not far to the top of the hill. Suddenly, a dragon stood in the way. Wait, I hope he's friendly," said Hong. "Look," said Biff, "there are bubbles coming out of his mouth." The dragon spoke. Over there with the mountain, he said, you have a long way to go. Help, said I, the journey looks dangerous. Below a black lake, across the lake, the land was dry and rocky. Beyond, there was a deep river and dark forest. Far away was a tall, gray mountain. Huge bubbles came out of the dragon's jaws. Answer this riddle, he said. How many sides does a bubble have? That's easy, said Han. It has two. The inside one and the outside, said he. Said, good, said the dragon. Now step into this bubble. Han stepped into the bubble. It began to float away. It stepped into a bubble, yelled Han. They all stepped inside a bubble and floated up and up. This is scary, said Biff. What if the bubbles pop? They floated on and on. At last, they began to float down to the black lake. I hope the bubbles don't pop here, yelled Chip. Then the bubbles popped and the children fell into the lake. Suddenly, a huge serpent rose out of the water. I don't like this adventure, said Biff. What's this? What is this? Said the serpent. The more it dries, the more it gets wet. It's easy, says Han. It's a tower. Oh, this question was what Han was talking about before they came to this adventure. And good, said the serpent. Now climb on my back. Yes, the serpent swam across the lake. How do you know the answer to all riddles, Han asked Han. I don't know, said Han. They just come to me. And goblins were waiting for the children. They pulled and pinched them. Ouch, that hurts, said Chip. Ha, you won't answer the next riddle, said one of the goblins. The goblins put the children in a cage. One of the goblins stole the magic key. Oh no, said Biff. Now we can't get back from this adventure. The goblin king spoke to him. Answer this, he said. How do you want to die? We don't want to die, said Chip. Han began to laugh. It's not funny, said Biff. We don't want to die. It's a riddle, said Han. Don't worry, I know the answer. What will happen? Next Monday, I'll read you part 2. Until then, bye!